All right. I came to the brilliant conclusion that I should initiate these from the bottom instead, because obviously I have a ton at the top. I mean, look when this thing is coming out versus the date when I downloaded this. I am so far behind these bitches. And so it's better, instead of like just being in the middle, like trying to keep track of where I stopped last time, instead, let's just start from the bottom and move up, and eventually we'll get to the end when everybody has stopped, you know, the apocalypse has come through, people have stopped uploading replays and whatnot. We'll get there. As always, playlist link in the bottom if you want to see all of the previous episodes of this. Timestamps as well if you want to look at which characters are being played and you don't want to see these new characters. You want to pretend you're still watching Chrono Phantasma where these motherfuckers didn't exist. Nice instant block. That sucks. Burst to keep him in the corner, and then you just dash straight into the corner yourself. I do kind of wonder, because initially Nine's dash looks so strong, but because it's very similar to Azrael's dash, and everybody knows, you know, from dealing with Chrono Phantasma, how goddamn good and difficult to punish his dash is unless you're directly in the corner. And so, you know, when you're watching it, it looks very similar to that. But there's actually a lot more. Oh, this is a nice rapid cancel. There's a lot more recovery to the end of her dash than Azrael's does. And so I feel like people respect it a bit too much, and if they start trying to, like right there, that should never have worked. She should never have taken that hit. Probably should have just hit her out of that. But granted, I am operating off of knowledge of her backdash, experience of her backdash. Versus, I don't know if her forward dash is different. It very well could be. I really just don't know. But right now, it kind of just seems like the Mai is getting hit. More so than, like, the Nine's doing something good. It's interesting, though, that I saw, I mean, obviously this is way past, but she did the command dash and canceled it after the D move. Can you do that regardless, or do they have to be, like, does it have to have hit them? Because I've personally never actually seen, like, any of the Mai players that are just leaning on that and just pressing it over and over and over. There is a solid amount of recovery to it. Yay! Exceed excels. And obviously that helps to mitigate that. So, like, why do I never see anybody use that? I don't know. And I never will know because it's a DLC locked character. How awesome would that be? It just occurred to me. You have characters that are DLC locked, but you're not able to use them in any of the modes except for training. Like, you always get them unlocked in training mode. Because that way, I mean, number one, it's awesome because you'd be able to have the ability to try that out, to try the character out beforehand and decide whether or not you like them. But then you have the whole economy question behind all of that, where like, okay, I'm not gonna get into economics in the middle of the match, it's Azrael getting his ass kicked. I guess there's not really much to say. But then you do have that question of like, is it worth it? Because how many people download the character, try her, and then are like, okay, nah, I don't really care about this character, I'm just not gonna play her. Versus, how many people do you have like me, who are on the fence, don't really know whether or not they want to play the character, and then they try her out, and they're like, oh, I actually really like this character. Okay, fuck it. She's worth the money. I'll buy her. And that is a question that I do not have any data to. She went through like three normals right there before she got bopped by the TP. That's amazing. Although I think the first one actually whipped and then he started the TP. Dude's just, like, he's jumping and pressing, but what? Throw tech, you're dead. Just fast forward that. Did he start with DP? From that distance? That thing has a terrible hitbox. Why would you ever do that? You deserve all the misery and suffering. Never mind, it just DPs again. I can't believe you didn't do it again. And it would've worked, too! That's the funny part. If he had done it again, it would've worked. But now he's dead. No! I don't know her overdrive well enough, but it didn't look like there was enough damage involved. I think if that had been the overdrive, like if she had half a second more and that had been the overdrive version of— oh god! Don't do four! I can't believe a fourth one worked. I would've thought because of the delay. Oh my god! Before the initiation of the first one. Nice! That got so sloppy at the end. Yeah, I think if they had like half a second more on their overdrive, that would have killed. But because it wore off, they got the normal version of their distortion, which is a fucking bummer. Then they lost the match because they didn't block too raw. Oh god. That just hurts. Oops, I don't know why I fast-forwarded there. I'm very skeptical because I remember— I mean, there's not a lot of bullet players, so obviously it's pretty easy to remember the gamer tags of bullet players, and I remember seeing this person and not being terribly impressed, so I was a little tempted to just delete these initially to begin with. That's just strange. They were holding barrier down the entire time until the second they actually needed it. I don't know if that was a reaction or just luck that she happened to jump right when— right at that moment in time, but if that was a reaction, that was damn fast. If this Mai were better about— see, like, she's just kind of throwing it out? Does that kind of just summarize this match so far? Because so far, that's kind of what it feels like. It just feels like the Mai just keeps tossing shit out, and the bullet is unlucky enough to keep running into it. Die? Oh, that's right. I always forget you can do that. For some reason, I never remember that you can do that going to super and have it connected. Just that correlates in my head to the end of a combo. Rebel three, if you don't have heat up, obviously. I am firmly on the side of this Mai player is just throwing constant shit at the wall and seeing what sticks. Like there was no confirm on that second hit. And they went to the overhead. I got— because the problem with playing like this, and believe me, I'm very well, because I used to play like this. I still do sometimes, where you just throw shit out and hope it works, is that there's no consistency behind it. Like, sometimes, just by the law of randomness, every single thing you do is gonna work, and you're gonna feel awesome. It's like, man, my game plan's so solid, I'm so good, etc., etc. And then you're gonna play against somebody who recognizes what the fuck you're doing, and they will never— you'll never touch them. And for a while— oh, off of a no-tech. Are they dead? I don't think they're dead. But they have very nearly lost the match off of a single no-tech. If I was that bullet, I would just be waiting until I got overdrive back. Okay, well that was bad. That was not good. That was so lucky! Holy shit! That was not good gameplay all around, man. The wheel of fate is turning. Rebel one. Action. Post. I legitimately have no clue how Mu plays in this game. I don't know. And there was no follow-up. Why did you allow that to work? God, she gets no damage off of it. Like, that used to be 1k more than that, free, every single time off of that particular hit confirmed. That was an odd. I wonder if they just. That was a mistake? Or if that was intentional? To try and, like, bait them into blocking high and then you go low? But, like. Bullet never stopped blocking low. So they just let that second hit go through that would have hit them. I don't know. It's an oddity. Why does that work? I don't know why. Just, there's something about it that. Holy shit, that damage! What? You're dead! Is she dead? I think she's dead! There has to be an overdrive in here somewhere that causes this to be a death. There must be! Where was the overdrive?! Okay. I mean, like, absolutely no overdrive usage, no meter usage. Off of that particular starter, there was no way in hell there was not a way to get a kill there. Especially after they just did what was essentially a 6k combo. Holy shit, I didn't know she could do that. So that must be a safe jump setup. Are they dead? There's the other rapid cam- Oh, but he doesn't have anything to do after that. Should have done 236B again, man. I don't know. Dude doesn't like it. Used it once. But there were two opportunities to use it for far greater effect. Never did. What was the anti-air? That really is a big problem with Susanoo in terms of, like, his intimidation factor. Because his only real low is 3C. And he can, there's no risk of him being able to, like, once he's at a certain range, you don't have to give a shit about throws at that point either. Because he can't just micro dash up and throw you, since he has, you know, that stupid ass startup to his dash in the first place. And now you're dead. What the fuck?! Oh boy! They were just enjoying the match so much. Just had to have another round. Why are you backdashing? Fuck it, just give him free moves. Why not? That's how you want to operate against Susanoo, right? Oh shit, you fucked up. This is what happens when you don't tech. I have no idea why so many people just don't tech ever. Dude made two stupid decisions. I don't know what the hell his decision was after that throw. But whatever he tried to hit confirm with was dumb, and he should never try that again, because super jump backwards? Son! And he decided not to tech once, and he got put in the corner for it. Actually, not even that he decided not to tech once. There were, what, like 5-6 opportunities in there for them to tech? And they never did it, and they got pushed to the corner, gave the other Susanoo a free power-up. You just cannot play like that. You can never give anything away for free and expect it to, like, and expect to be able to come back from that. I mean, sure, it's possible. Where was the spark pull? This is hurting me. I'm actually not sure why that didn't work. Maybe they late canceled the 6B a little bit? I don't know. Please do so much damage. Okay, now it's kind of, well, fuck. I'm gonna say, like, this isn't even a, this is just a regular corner combo. What?
What?
And he could have killed off of that! That sucked. I mean, that doesn't suck. Like, good, your wake up super didn't work. It still sucks. Like, I don't know, man. So many bad decisions that I'm watching right now. And I hate that kind of, like, backseat player, right? Where you're just constantly like, oh man, if I was doing that, I would have done this, this, and this. But it's like, those were just such obvious, stupid decisions. Because a lot of the time when that happens, when, you know, like a commentator is backseat playing, a lot of the time it's not really a, like, a hugely questionable thing, right? Like, that was definitely, there wasn't anything particularly bad about the decision they made, but for some reason they're just getting judgmental about it. Or alternatively, you'll have people who are like, so, like, when I'm talking and I'm like, oh man, surely they could have killed off of that. I feel like, you know, they had something in their movement repertoire that they could have killed off of that. You'll have commentators who are like, oh man, they fucked that up. That was their chance to win. Like, they're saying it as if it is an absolute fact, while we all know they don't actually know whether or not that's an absolute fact. That's always irked me, so I try to avoid that. And I'll freely admit, you know, like, when I don't know things. Ooh, nice! Did he? So doing my backseat thing again. I feel like because he had the weak point and he had meter, he would have been able to toss him back down to the ground. No, maybe not. Because of the distance thing. Now off of JD where it knocks them back further. It's really, I never, because I haven't learned it myself, I've never figured out the exact range of using JD and then being able to land, dash, TK cancel into Rekka's and still be in range where that actually hits. But if that was possible, I'm pretty sure he could have killed. But now that I'm thinking about it, I think the distance might have been off and he wouldn't have been able to land the Rekka's in order to get the damage he would need to then kill with a super. That was a good rapid cancel. Because usually most people in that scenario would just rapid cancel and dash away. I mean, that's, you know, a fairly riskless version of it. He took a bit of a risk by rapid canceling into a button. I really don't understand why people say Ragna is shit. Like, I understand, oh yeah, Ragna is not continuum shift levels of strong anymore. But I cannot wrap my head around the people that think, have we seen this one? Because I distinctly remember this color. I think we've seen this one. I'm going to go off of that assumption that we have because I don't want to risk it.
Blade is turning. Rebel, one. Action.
It's been like, okay, there we go. I'm gonna say it's been about 15 seconds and literally nothing has happened. But now it's how cock and stuff we have. You gotta block something. DP here? Oh! Surely dead. Nope, fucked up. This Jin manages to run it all the way back, I will be very impressed. I don't really know how they're doing it so far. Like, they're getting a lot of hits that I feel like nobody should really get. Oh, shit! You just might... That's how Kaka plays. So scared. You can't play that scared in a fighting game. Like, I feel like how this Taukaka is playing with this kind of attempt of, like, hit and run and be very, very careful about when you go in for your hits would only really work if you've optimized your movement, and I don't feel like this player has. Please don't let the same thing happen. Yeah, it's like, I mean, once the offense gets going, you can clearly see this Jin is not comfortable at all being on defense in general. And that's how Kaka just gets to run a train on him. But, I don't know, man. It's... Yeah, it's just always so awkward when you see somebody who is so blatantly bad on defense. Especially when it's two people who are incredibly bad on defense. And so it's kind of just like, you know, it winds up being whoever gets the first hit just wins, because neither player really knows how to block, they don't really know how to counter poke or anything like that, and so they just kind of guess. That was a real hit confirmed. Taukaka very may well have been dead twice over now. Yeah, that Taukaka has absolutely zero capability at finishing their work. That Jin gave them so many opportunities to take that. Always hurts. That was a very long, unless there might have been startup of another move after that, but that feels like that was a really long window for her drive to be counter hit. I can't believe that worked. Generally off of jump ins is kind of the worst time to overdrive. So just land in the cover. Ooh, that was a nice bait! They died from that? Since it was a fatal counter? Oh my god, choking! There's so many chokes in these matches so far. Where was some attempt at an anti-air? It just feels like so many people don't have the capability to adapt to a scenario they didn't foresee. Like, their setup didn't end in exactly the spot that they expected it to, and now they don't really know what to do. They're blocking pretty well, though. Got out of the corner. Oh, they got bopped by the drive. All right, this one's gonna, I was gonna do one more match, but I got some shit to do. Thank you for watching. I got plenty more. Good God, I have so many more. I'll see you next time.